With 1 month to go before the Tour de France sets off, the Critérium du Dauphiné is a perfect training ground for those wanting to test themselves on the Alps. This year the programme was busy, with little room for the sprinters. Individual time trial, team time trial, and four summit finishes all came together to sort out the favourites. Several names emerged for the final victory to succeed 2017 surprise winner Jakob Fuglsang. For Team Sky, Geraint Thomas and Mikhail Kwiatkowski. For AG2R La Mondiale, Romain Bardet, who has finished on the Tour de France podium for the last 2 years. Vincenzo Nibali returned to the Dauphiné after 3 years of absence. Perhaps a little further down the list, but equally notable, were Dan Martin and Adam Yates, as well as recent winner of Paris-Nice, Marc Soler. Sky seized the leader's yellow and blue jersey right from the prologue. The Polish man Mikhail Kwiatkowski was the quickest, but the biggest scare was given by Geraint Thomas. A fall without consequence, except only that it wasn't the Welshman who would take the leader's jersey on the first day. The two following days brought mountainous routes, and not all the sprinters joined the action. From among the favourites on Monday, it was the South African Daryl Impey who settled the massive sprint of Saint-Just-Saint-Rombert. The day after, it was Pascal Ackermann who made his presence felt. The German from Boro-Hansgrohe crossed the line first in Belleville. Daryl Impey took third place and, thanks to the bonus, the leader's jersey as well. Only for a day, however, until Sky put things back in order with the team time trial on Wednesday. 35 kilometres and one victory later, Mikhail Kwiatkowski was again restored to the head of the column, and Geraint Thomas climbed the overall ranking to fourth place, giving us some indication of what was to come. Thursday was the first mountain finish in Lanzon-Vercors, a mid-sized mountain with a finish for the punchers. Julien Alaphilippe of Team Quickstep did away with the group of favourites and took charge of the final few metres, right under the noses of none other than Dan Martin, Geraint Thomas and Romain Bardet. On Friday, the route was no less steep and arduous. 12.7 kilometres at 7% on average to rally Valmorel and rattle the overall. Dan Martin took charge all alone and brought himself his first victory on the routes of Dauphiné. Runner-up on this stage, Geraint Thomas took the leader's jersey along with more than a minute's lead on his competitors before the last two chapters of 2018. The next day, Geraint Thomas held off his adversaries and left them behind in the last few metres of the stage up to La Rossière, but it was a survivor from the day's breakaway who stood his ground on this rugged stage. 48 kilometres of climb and an average gradient of 7%, none of which perturbed Peo Bilbao, the Spaniard from Team Asana, who recently finished 6th in the Giro d'Italia. It was time for this Dauphiné to come to an end for certain riders. Daniel Navarro was caught napping on the line in Saint-Gervais during the last stage on Sunday by Adam Yates, who detonated the end of this race. Geraint Thomas cracked and conceded several seconds, but all the same brought home this Dauphiné 2018. His second week-long Grand Tour, 2 years after Paris-Nice in 2016.